I think that doctors generally have been a bit slow to talk about climate change as an issue of health equity because, frankly, we haven't been educated to understand it. And that's why it's been really important for me as an educator to make climate change such a critical part of medical training, because I do believe that climate change is a public health crisis and that doctors and healthcare professionals, nurses, social workers have such a critical role in making clear how this is a public health crisis. My name is Gaurab Basu. I'm a primary care physician, a health equity educator, and a climate advocate. So I keep busy with a lot of activities. I teach medical residents and students. I write a lot. We organize community climate gatherings. We have a committee at our hospital for climate health. I do local advocacy around local policies that impact my patients. And I work for a global nonprofit called the Child in Need Institute and many other global organizations. Health equity is this notion that we should have a fair healthcare system, that we should build systems that allow everyone's dignity and humanity to be honored and respected.
Does that feel okay?
Yeah.
Climate change is fundamentally an issue of health equity. And this is because climate change disproportionately impacts communities of color and poor communities here and around the world. I'm honored to be a primary care doctor at a community health center that takes care of a remarkable and dynamic immigrant patient population.
How are you? All right, I'm going to listen to you.
And my patients here in Massachusetts, I can see the direct connections between climate change, health equity, and racial justice. When a patient comes in with uncontrolled diabetes, so many times the root causes of that disease process is not just insulin or sugar levels in their blood, but actually issues of poverty and structural racism. It's critical that I educate my patients. It's critical that I explain how we can mitigate the impacts of things like air pollution to their health. So if I have a patient with COPD and respiratory disease, it's important for me to make sure they know which days could have poor air quality. I came into medicine because I really believe that we're put on this earth to take care of one another, that we got to look out for each other and make sure that we all have the opportunity to thrive. And so to be able to sit with patients and know what medications or treatment plans might improve their lives, it's just a tremendous joy for me. So the UN IPCC report of 2018 was an awakening moment for me. Throughout my career, I've done a lot of thinking and work on issues like human rights and global health, and racial justice and health equity. The piece that was missing for me is I had not realized that in order for us to take care of each other, we have to take care of our planet. The IPCC report helped me understand that climate change is a threat to all the things that I care about, and that the fight for human rights, the fight for racial justice, is intertwined and interconnected with our fight to sustain our planet. There's a lot of challenges to climate change, and there's a lot of vested interests in making profits off of our current systems. But on the flip side, there's historic and monumental momentum that is occurring right now, mostly because of the youth movements across the world, point us in a new direction, to point us to a future that is just, that is sustainable, that is healthy. So ultimately, I believe in our ability to rise to the challenge that climate change poses, to find the solutions that we need to enact, and to work together to sustain this planet and create a future that our children deserve.
Hey everybody, you might have noticed this was a little different than our typical programming. It's one of five video profiles we're launching that are a part of the GRIS 50, our annual list of 50 people who are doing cool work in climate and the environment. You can check out that full list here or in the description below.